That's the worst part. Yeah. We cannot even order food for ourselves, like even having money.
What will you pick?
I think you should try. They're like shocked, like, how come you're paying so much? Like, we pay so less. Yeah, 2.5 more than we pay in India. I like those buns, like, I think it's called baluchki.
Baluchki?
Yeah. Now we go to hospitals. And we, they show us like the practicals we are doing. Yeah, I would translate everything on the phone and then I would check it out and then I would eat it.
Hey guys, my name is Elena and I'm an expat living and working in Odessa. Usually in my vlogs I talk about my own experiences, but Ukraine is home to so many expats from all over the world. Some of them come here to study, others to work, yet others to retire and travel the country. Regardless, each one of them has their own unique story. And in this new series, Interview with an Expat, I want to talk to different foreigners from different countries and ask them the quintessential question. Why did you move to Ukraine?
I'm here with Aditi, who is a medical student. She's also a fellow YouTuber. Aditi has her own vlog in which she talks about the Ukrainian lifestyle, her travels in Ukraine, and her medical student things that she needs to do at the university. So Aditi, thanks so much for taking the time to come here. My first question would be, where are you from, obviously, and how did you decide to come to Ukraine?
Okay, so basically I'm from India and I decided to come here as in India we have a really bad situation about the colleges, like in getting admission in the medical universities. So you need to have a good percentage and the fee structure is very much there. So I decided to come to Ukraine and I already found a very nice university here.
So could you remember the first time when you came to Ukraine, you know, what month it was, what season, what were your first impressions?
I came to Ukraine in May. That's first of all, I had a flight from India to Kyiv and that was a pretty long flight because in May, I think it's already springtime. So the weather was really nice and we landed around 6 and 7 and we were already homesick till then because like we had a really bad day. We were leaving our family there.
Was it your first big international travel?
No, I've already been to Dubai and from a school trip, but not for like really such long time. For like living, it's my first time and I have traveled before as well.
What are the things that you find most strange and like unusual about Ukraine?
In India, you mainly have the English as your first language, like in schools also. And in our official language also English. And when we came here for the first time, the thing was, it was all Ukrainian, Russian. That's the worst part. Yeah. We cannot even order food for ourselves. Like even having money, we cannot even order. So that was the worst situation we had here.
Was there somebody who was helping you out for the first time, you know, ordering food, getting things?
So we had our seniors here, so they helped us. As first we came, we were living in hostels. People were really helpful. We didn't come in contact with a lot of Ukrainian people at that time. Only Indians and people who were usually speaking English, they were helping us. And then we had our consultant with us. So he, like they told us everything, where you get a grocery from, where you get everything from. So that's the that was a good part.
You've told me already so much about your experience, but I'm really curious and I think other people would be also curious. What about the cost of living here in Ukraine? How is it different from India? You know, how much you pay for the apartment?
So I had to pay for the apartment for the first month and then I had to pay to the broker like the half amount of the apartment charges. So my apartment is a studio apartment. So I found it from a person who is like a broker here. So he charged me 8,000 hryvnias in the starting for my apartment. And then we have the extra electrical charges and then we have the water charges extra. Means not included in those 8,000.
But how much per month is like those extra charges?
Those extra charges are not too much. Like we pay around 500 for electricity and I think it's 280 or 300 for water. And then you have the Wi-Fi recharge, that's for 220 hryvnias. And then we have the grocery and then we have extra things like the toiletries. So that around costs between $150 to $200 per month. Yeah. So that's expensive here, because in India, like, you convert Indian rupee to USD, so that's 75 for one USD.
You're paying almost twice more here than you would pay in India?
Yeah, 2.5 more than we pay in India.
What about the price for university? Is it more expensive for you here than if you were a Ukrainian studying at the medical? Are you paying more than Ukrainians do?
Yeah, we are paying more than Ukrainians do. But I really don't know the exact amount which they are paying. But the students whom I have met here, they, when I tell them, it's like, they're like shocked, like, how come you're paying so much? Like, we pay so less. In the first year, we have extra charges, all university stuff, application forms. So first year, it's around $10,000. And then later, from the second to sixth year, it keeps increasing. But this year, it was 5,800 or $6,000. Yeah, so that's the amount, and it will keep on increasing till the sixth year. For this education in India, I would pay around like 2 to 3 crores.
How much would that be in dollars?
Dollars, I think I'll have to calculate.
We will calculate and we will let you know. Don't worry about it. How is the quality of education at your university currently? Are you satisfied? Do you like it? Is it worth it?
We had to study a lot. A lot of struggle we did. Like, we were staying in hostel, and then we had to come every day for 1 hour. It would take us to come. But studying here, it's really good. In India, you have like every 6 months, you have your exams, like the midterm and then the finals. But here you have a topic, and then you study for that topic, and then you go back to that full topic, and then you have an exam for that topic. We have good teachers here. They speak in English. Now we go to hospitals and they show us like the practicals we are doing. So that's a really good experience here.
How does your typical day look like as a student at the medical university? How much free time you have? What do you do?
Sometimes we have a class at 8:30, and sometimes we have at 12. If it's at 8, it will get over at 1. And if it is at 12, so it will get around over at 3. So that's a particular, not fixed routine, but yeah. Till 3 o'clock, we are busy with university. And then after that, we come home, we cook our food, and then we take some rest. And then I usually go to gym. So around 6 o'clock, I go to gym. And till 8 o'clock, I'm free there. After that, I come back home. I have a bit of my food. And then I start studying until 12 o'clock I study.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And then after that, I'm free. I go to my bed every day. That's the same routine on Saturday and Sunday. I usually make videos like for YouTube, for my channel. The channel name is Explore with Aditi. So you guys can go and check it out there. So you will get to know more about the Indians, what they're doing here. So now basically we are going to an Indian restaurant. It has really nice food. So you guys can come and check it out. It's Indian tandoori. We're going to have a nice Indian tea and Indian food.
Oh,
so
I love
Alina
it.
So Alina will have good reactions there.
Hopefully. Was it difficult for you to come here as a vegetarian in Ukraine? Can you find dishes that you can eat non-Indian, obviously?
Yeah. In starting, it is very difficult to find food. So I decided I would help. Like, I would translate everything on the phone, and then I would check it out, and then I would eat it. And even if my friends were eating something, I would ask them, like, is there a non-veg in it? Is there non-veg in it? So it's very hard to find vegetarian food here.
Do you have any favorite, maybe Ukrainian dishes which are safe for you as a vegetarian?
I like those buns. Like, I think it's called baluchki.
Bulochki?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I like those. It is with cheese, it's with potato, it's with cabbage.
Oh, yeah.
It has many varieties.
What will you pick? What will you pick?
I think you should try. Do you want to have, first of all, let's order chai?
Yes.
Let's have chai. This is a samosa, and this potato samosa. And we are ordering tea. That's masala tea. And for the main dish,
We are having chili paneer and chapatis, that's chapati, and that's Indian roti, and we are having aloo paratha.
So Aditi, you're obviously an expert on Indian food, and I think every Ukrainian would like to know the answer to the question, what are the best places to eat Indian in Odessa? What would you recommend?
For Indian food, you really don't have many restaurants in Odessa, but you have Indian Tandoori, you have Hotel London, and you also have one more restaurant which is recently opening here, but I have tried that food, their food in Lviv. So you guys can go check out, its name is Lotus, Zaika of India, so you guys can go check out their restaurant.
How many spoons do you usually?
I usually put two. And you?
Yeah, two.
One?
For me too. Yeah, I will try it the IDT way. So
and
let's
you have chutneys.
Dig in.
This is the red one. And this is green chutney.
This is
with mint.
With mint and the red
and this
one?
This one is, I think, chili.
Okay. Maybe careful on the chili. Oh, so good. I actually don't like tea with sugar that much, but I feel like the Indian chai is really good with some sugar. I can feel the spices started to kick in. I put some chili sauce, but so far it's manageable. Indian cuisine can be very spicy and can be also non-spicy.
It's up to you how you want to make it.
Actually, I think there is a misconception about Indians that all the Indians eat
spicy. It's very spicy, but it's not. It depends on the person, like how they want to cook or how they want to eat. So it's not that spicy as well. Like even I don't eat so much of spices. Like I don't eat red chili.
This is aloo paratha. This is bread stuffed with potatoes that I was telling you about. And what is this?
And this is the chili paneer. That's a type of Indian plus Chinese mix. So let's try it out and you can see the colors.
It looks delicious. This is my first time trying chili paneer.
Chili paneer.
I don't think I had it before. Or maybe I had it but I forgot.
That's the chapati, which we were telling about.
This is just flatbread, right?
Yeah.
I'm a bigger fan of the
paratha.
Of the paratha because it has potatoes.
Yeah.
It's, in my opinion, one of the best breakfasts around the world. Aloo paratha with curd.
First advice I would like to give everybody who is coming to Ukraine, not only students, everybody, just before coming, just try to learn some points about Ukrainians, like Ukrainian language, first of all. That's the main thing that you should learn when coming here. And second of all, just try Ukrainian food, because food is a must, I think, for living. So you should try everything, because you think that they don't have spices in their food and it's different. So you should try it out. That is also very nice. And for weather here, you should be prepared about the weather. Like in winters, it's going to be really cold. So you should be prepared about
really
that.
Really cold.
Yeah, very cold. It's October right now and we have temperature here right now. It's around 7 and it feels like 4. So you can imagine what's going to be in December and January.
It was a lovely interview. Thank you so much for sharing your life story and insight with us. Well, you guys, don't forget to follow Aditi on her channel. Like and subscribe to this blog if you enjoyed this sort of format. Interview with expats. This is something new on my channel. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.